Mum, come on, floss. Yes! No, no, Laura, show her. Show her, show her. Show her, show her. Morning crew. You guys will be glad I didn't film first thing this morning. I was like in the worst mood ever, and I don't even know why. I think it's just because I'm really tired. And you know when like tiny little things just irritate you, like walking downstairs and like go to get a coffee mug and that irritates me, and then just like generally like everything, I tried to change my memory card on my camera and that irritated me. So then I went and had some quiet time, which I always do in the mornings, and I was a bit like, I don't want to do it this morning because I've got to get up early. I have to get up like 40 minutes earlier to do it, and I was like, I just want to stay in bed, but I was like, no, that's not going to make you feel any better. So yeah, got up, had my quiet time, and now I'm like on cloud nine. So we're going to have a good day today, guys. Too many people around singing too loudly. I'm sweaty. Why am I wearing a jumper? Because it's a great one, that's why. But I'm gonna take it off now. Ready, release the beasts. Gutted, I was gonna have a banana pancake. We don't have any bananas. They are back with a vengeance, by the way. I'm having those every day, unless I don't have a banana. So we're gonna have to have my Weet-Bix. Have you had yours? Changed my mind. I'm gonna have porridge. I've got a craving for something warm, I don't know why, and it feels dodgy and squishy. I'm so indecisive with food. Hey guys, so it's Tuesday and I don't know what day. 17th, I think. And I have not vlogged at home for ages. I actually didn't vlog last week because it was heartbeat before and I'd made 3 vlogs and I was like, I just need a little bit of a rest. But I had like major withdrawal symptoms from vlogging, which is great, like means I love doing it, which is awesome. So what has been happening, last week was a really good week. Yeah, it was really, really good. Everything was going well. What else happened? Oh yeah. I took Molly out for the first time, and I'm really sorry I didn't vlog it, but like I said, I needed a break. But he was amazing. I took him to a pole work clinic, and he was really, really, really good. I don't think I've even mentioned I did this on social media, but there we go, guys. He was really good. a little bit braver than Joey, but he is the cocky one, so. But yeah, I'll definitely film next time I go out. So what happened? What else has happened? On the weekend, I went to a gathering called Shift. And this is a pre-warning for anybody, because there's been a few of you, who have said that I'm not allowed to talk about other things apart from horse-related stuff because I'm a horse vlogger. My social media platforms are for horse riding. I'm going to have to break it to you. That's just not how it's going to go down. Because I'm not just a horse rider. I'm so much more than a horse rider. I absolutely love horse riding. I love doing it, I enjoy it, like it's my passion, but it doesn't define me. Like I'm a whole person, there's more to me than that.
And I do think that that's where we go a little bit wrong sometimes, is when we're trying to improve our mindset or trying to improve our riding, we just focus on the riding. We don't look at the whole holistic thing. Like, for example, if your riding isn't going well, but you're going out every night getting absolutely teetotaled, and you know, you're clubbing, you're partying, all this, and you're getting up, you're tired, you're a bit ratty, because we all get tired when we're ratty, and you're wondering why your riding's not going well, you know, quite important. Also, if you know you're not looking after yourself, like fitness wise, nutrition wise, and you're wondering why your horse isn't going straight and you're not looking after yourself, you can't expect the horse to if you're not. So anyway, I'm going off on one, but basically all I'm saying is I'm really sorry, but I'm going to talk about what helps me. I'm going to talk about me as a whole person. And if you guys haven't noticed, God is a massive part of my life now. I know, she said it, alarm bells going off. Quick, get off. No, I'm joking. But seriously, I've been having quite a lot of inner battles with this one, and I know I keep talking about it, but I've been having some major inner battles with it, of like, don't talk about God, don't talk about your faith, it's too like controversial, there's too many people who don't like it, and you might lose followers, and it's not going to help you as a business. And then I'm like, what is going on? Like, I'm letting a few comments, a bit more than a few, kind of define where my content's going, and that is just not what it's about. So yeah, anyway, I went to Shift. I'm getting sweaty. Woo! I went to Shift, which is a gathering of Christians, 20 to 30 year olds. There was 350 of us. It's called Shift because it's all about shifting culture. So basically, they spoke to us on reviving our heart, redeeming the city, basically like how we can go into our local areas or like city or whatever and do good and help it. And it's not about like kind of draining where you're living, like you're just taking, it's about putting back. So what did they say? It's about servanthood, not extraction, and how we can go out into our local places and basically help and try and like give the love and just help people. Because they were talking about like they've got someone now into the government that's for loneliness, and they were like, that's not what's going to help. What's going to help is all of us going out and helping each other, and human to human helping each other through the tough times, you know, like love thy neighbor and all that. So that's what happened, and I got a few video clips of it. Like, one thing, check this girl out. She did open mic night, dropped a testimony. Literally the best thing ever.
It all started when I got sick. Shouldn't trust the Christ, but I blamed him quick. All I had to do was touch the hem of his garment, then I would be healed, but no, I wasn't on it. I chose a life of stress and depression, thinking I was free but under Satan's oppression. But then I gave my life back to Christ. I'm not hungry, I ate the bread of life. I'm not thirsty, I drink the living water. I'm back now like the prodigal daughter.
And it's funny because the other day people were like, oh, if you become a Christian you have to become so boring and wear certain things and say certain things and be in a certain way. Not at all, guys. Literally all you have to do is have a relationship with Jesus. Like, I mean, come on, she's the coolest thing I've ever seen. But anyway, and then we had some like worship time, which was really cool, and we're all there like, woo! Were sermons and talks, and we had Baroness Philippa Stroud, who works in Parliament, come in and talk about it. She's a lady that started this massive movement around poverty, like helping poverty, and she went to Hong Kong when she was 20 and worked with people who were getting off drugs, actually people who were on drugs, and she said that people had told her she wasn't going to be able to do it because she had a bit of a posh accent and she was a girl and no one would take her seriously, and she's literally killing it. Like, she's changing a nation. Anyway, I'm going to go and ride now, but I just saw something and I want to do it. Trap, money, penny. This shit got me in my feelings. Gotta be real with it. Yep. Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. That's the OTD version of Kiki, do you love me?
For anyone who doesn't know that, what that is, by the way, it's like a challenge, a Drake challenge for his new song. And people do it getting out of their cars. So I did it getting out of my car or my transport. Anyway, we're gonna get down to business now. Mum's coming to teach me on Wilfred and Eagle.
I don't even know why I signed up. No, you make that noise that I make. Yeah. Well, push for a little more at home. What? You're flying out the back. Oh, well, you'll have to sit better. Might have to take that bit out. Not because of you. Right, now I need to watch you.
Apologises for not filming because she says she can't
do everything.
But I say you guys want to see it.
You guys will have to wait.
Ooh! Mic drop!
There you go.
The two big boys are ridden now. Wilf was good. The only thing is, his saddle, the physio said that the saddle's making him a little bit sore, so I changed it, and then Sue took a look, and she's actually making him one now, which is super exciting, because that's what Eagle's in now. Oh, I'll show you guys in a minute, hold on. And then, yeah, what else was I gonna say? Oh yeah, sorry, so his saddle didn't fit, so he's wearing the semi-flex at the moment, and because we're spilt uphill and the semi-flex makes you sit up, it's pushing me back, and I'm kind of like, bah, I feel like I'm always falling back, my legs are flying forwards, so it's a bit difficult doing the, like, just doing everything, so I think I'm gonna have to put him back into his other saddle for this week, which is a bit annoying. I don't know, saddles are a nightmare, aren't they? Eagle had a lesson yesterday with David, so did Wilf, but Eagle had quite a hard lesson, so I just stretched him today, and I'm not sure how much footage we got because the guy came down to the skip, and I feel like I'm blabbing. Anyway, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, I'll show you the saddle when we get back in. But yeah, that's that. I'm now gonna ride Fling, who is Belinda Gatlin's horse, and he came all the way over from Dubai not long ago, and yeah, just getting his strength up and his fitness, so I'm gonna do him now. Oh, this is Lauren, everyone.
Hi.
Some work experience. Mum, come on, floss. Yes! No, no, Laura, show her. Show her. Come on, do it. No, so there we go. Yes, go Laura. Go.
It's like having a floss between your legs. No, not between your legs, between your body.
Yes, Laura's got it. Yes.
Oh, I've lost it.
Yes. Here's Fling. The most gorgeous little pony of all the land. Oh, he's so cute. Your mummy misses you very, very much.
He says, hi, Mummy Belinda, I met you. He's looking at me like, you are mental.
I've got a new mummy though.
Oh, burn.
She knows I do. So I buy him bananas while she's not here.
Yeah, buy me bananas. I didn't have any this morning. I stole one of your bananas yesterday, did you notice?
It's not mine, mate.
Oh, I stole one of your bananas yesterday, did you notice? Sorry. I bet you were like,
oh, bloody Nora, she's licked my bananas.
Oh. I'm sorry. So the reason he's getting lined up against the wall is because Flingaling's mama only has one leg because she lost, what, how did she lose it?
She lost it in a point-to-point accident. I think it got stuck in the stirrup. They tried to save it, but it just...
So she's the most incredible rider. You watch her, right?
You
wouldn't know. And there's us, like, complaining about struggling with riding. We have two legs. And she likes absolutely killing it with one. So anyway, yeah, to make it easier for her to get on, we've taught him to line up against the wall. So, yeah. Carson saddle that I've got. If Carlsberg did saddles, it would be this. So this bit is full of air, so what they can do, they fit it to the horse, like when they come. So if you feel the saddle's tipping you back or forwards, they can like pump more air into it or take less air out, so your position's perfect. Like, it's incredible. And also, like, you can't see it, but it's so soft. So soft. Nice.
Just gonna tack Annabelle up for Mum to ride because Frankie is on mummy duty now. It's summer holiday, so she's not riding Annie for a while. So we're doing her. So, shall I meet you over there?
Huh?
Shall I meet you over there?
Yeah, I'll be 2 seconds
from there. Okay, I've got the saddle and the bridle. That's about it. Let me get some boots.
I see you, Annabelle, hiding. Annabelle is off to the school. Jaff Cake Rolly one. Oh, Mum's riding Roll for a bit, by the way, just because she needs to just get her strength and fitness up, and Mum's good with the lazier ones, I'm not so good, so. Joey, I saw that, it's caught on camera. You trying to steal the plants. The 4-year-olds got ridden yesterday, so they're going on the walker today. And Jaffa's gonna block the camera view. Good one, Jaff.
I forgot to say as well, Abby is on holiday at the moment, that's why she's not here. But also, if you guys saw on my social media, she's actually going to another job in
beginning of August that she's got offered, which is really exciting because the whole point of people being here is that they get like the work, like for the working people, is they get the work experience and then they can go out into the world. And it just so happened that she got offered a job and they kind of needed her to start earlier than her being here a full year, if that makes sense. So she's going. So we are looking for someone. I think we found someone though. We had like 54 people get in contact, which is really cool, really exciting. So we're gonna have a new working pupil soon, which is amazing. But that is why I'm working on the yard more at the moment and not doing the officey stuff, which is slightly scary because the officey stuff's like going brrrr. But that's fine. We got this. You got this. You got this. That is just disgusting. That is Spiller's mash with oats. I'm gonna have to clean that up now. Digger! Wasn't me, he says. Wasn't me.
Laura the cougar.
Yeah, Laura the cougar.
Laura the cougar.
Don't, she hasn't got flies, don't know. I let you into a secret. Yesterday her pants matched her shirt.
Where have you gone? Where are you? Oh, there you are. Welcome to OTD. It's Marshu, everyone. Mummy's retired pony. He said, I'm loving retirement, I am. I'm a loving retirement. Rue, Frankie's little baby, and then our little baby at the bottom.
How are they the same age? How does that work? He's massive. He's only what? Three now? They're two.
Sprout. It's lunchtime. So we're all in lunch now. We're about to interview Mum about something in a minute, by the way.
Yeah, I'm busy.
Hold on to your hats. I was going to say seats then. Hold on to your hats because it's going to be a feisty interview with Libby Tower. We're having to persuade Mum into doing this interview because she's like, I'm not taking interviews today, so.
Oh, there you are.
Stop it. Right, let me do this and then
it's
I'll come
the,
and interview.
It's on the front page.
Stop it. Don't worry about it. Right. Basically. Where are we going with this? What are we struggling with?
Why teenage kids can't communicate directly on a phone line, really.
Okay, title of this controversial chat. What is happening to our generation?
Or show any initiative on doing things
okay, we'll get to that in a minute.
So hold on.
I need to...
Right, okay, hang on. So, this job, either their mothers do it for them.
Mum, no one knows what the context. Give some context.
Right.
People are applying for a job.
Yeah,
right,
the apprenticeship job. There so, either their mothers ring up on behalf of them.
Yeah.
Or they send me a message asking me for a link. And then, when they can't find the link, they then message me back to send more details on how to find the link. If I send them a telephone number, they can't dial the number and speak to a person on the end of the phone. They are incapable of it. So they either email or text. They have no direct conversation.
So what do you think is going wrong with the generation?
I don't know. I just think that nobody speaks to anybody and it's absolutely ridiculous.
Do you think they've lost a little bit of work ethic as well?
Oh, and as for work, well, don't get me on that.
Okay, my opinion on this. Laura, chirping if you feel you need to.
Nobody will turn up for this.
Personally, I think that
like everything she's saying is true, but I do think that like social media and all that sort of thing is not helping anyone. I think it's the way the world's starting to get molded. I think schools are starting to do it as well. On social media, everyone thinks that everything's quick and easy to get, so they don't think they have to put any work into it. Like even you said, didn't you, when you came here, you were like, you weren't expecting it to be as hard as it actually is, because on the vlogs it might look real easy, but there's so much work that goes into the back of it, and that's literally for anything. Like, you can look at Beyonce and be like, I wish I was her, but like, she's grafting every day. Like, yeah, that's what I have to say on it. What about you, Laura?
Lauren saying that, you know, it is harder work here than she thought it would be because she watches the vlogs, but like, actually this is a really easy place to work in the sense that We're not overforced for the amount of staff that we've got. You know, we've got a quad bike. You don't go poo picking and have to push a wheelbarrow around and keep coming back to empty it. You know,
that's
like, the yard's not spread out on a massive scale. It's all kind of quite compact, and it is quite an easy place to work. But people come in and they just don't have a clue. Or give them, like, a few jobs to do in a couple of hours, they're absolutely cream crackered, and a couple of days they've got blisters, and my hands are sore.
Kids, they sit down going like this instead of going outside and playing.
This is not us having a go, by the way. This is literally like what every person.
Yeah, because
every person.
Yeah,
and also when I started doing it at the age of 16, like I would say, I got a shock to it.
I think
I was really tired when I first started doing it.
Yeah. Obviously,
but it's kind of pushing through.
You do come up to it, but I don't think people can expect to come into work on a yard like this and find it really hard. Most people start at the bottom, so if they've got their own horses or they've done part-time work in yards, and then you work up to being in a professional yard. I think people expect that they're going to come in here, and like, there's people who have applied for jobs before who are like, oh, I need some I need to improve my canter pirouettes, so I thought I could do them on Olivia's horses. Like, that ain't never gonna happen. Like,
yeah, they're missing the graft side.
You have to start at the bottom and work your way up. Like, you're not gonna walk in and be a head girl when you're 20, 21 years old.
And also, isn't it? Like, getting where you want to get. It's not like, I'm just going to do this, and this, and then I'm going to be there. It's like,
I think you have to prove yourself. You have to come in and you have to work and prove yourself that you can do it. And then you'll get breaks.
That's what I did.
Someone will let you warm up their horse for them, which at the time, when you're young, you'll think, bloody hell, this is amazing.
Yeah.
It's like the best day ever. I know when I first started warming up Olivia's horses, I was like, I've made it. This is great. But I didn't do that right at the very beginning. I came in and I showed Libby that I could do it and that she could trust me. And then, like you said, you get the breaks and you get the good bits. But don't come in expecting to have all those good bits from the start, because...
So I want to hear what you guys think about this controversial topic that Mum and Laura and I and Lauren just spoke about. Let me know what you think. So I mucked out and I'm waiting for somebody to arrive, so I'm going to go do some work, probably edit the vlog. It's very mixed matched, isn't it? Like outside, inside. But yeah, I'm teaching tonight, so I need to get some work done. So life really is not simple. My good mood's like disintegrated. Oh, don't cry. This is such a long story to explain on the vlog, but I'll try and explain it quickly. Basically, I put that challenge I did that's in this vlog, I put it out on social media today, like in a little clip. And one person has messaged me, and this is someone that had a go at me for saying that I didn't like Nicki Minaj's song that was talking about girls not sleeping with guys unless they're rich, which I didn't agree with, so I said, I don't like the song. I kind of put my opinion out on social media. But one person didn't like that I'd said this, and they said that I should leave them alone and not have an opinion. And also, I listen to rap music, so who am I to talk? And because I'm new to Christianity, yeah, I still do listen to some rap music that maybe I shouldn't. And I understand that, but it's not a quick turnaround when you become a Christian. And also, she said that, you know, it's easy for me because I'm a reborn Christian and churchgoer, so I should know better, all this sort of thing. And I do find it's a really challenging thing, because a lot of music now, I don't really agree with the lyrics and I don't really like what they advertise. But anyway, I put it out on social media, this challenge, and they sent me a message saying, I think it's absolutely hilarious you've done the In My Feelings challenge. Are you a Christian or are you a pro rapper? And yeah, it's just really, really upset me. Really, really upset me. Because then I asked some advice off someone and they said, yeah, you shouldn't have done it. And it's just really difficult, like, being on social media and being in the public eye so much, every single little choice you make has consequences. Lulu. I'm just really struggling, like, I'm really, really struggling, and I feel like I'm getting judged a lot. I literally didn't even think about it. Like, I haven't really listened to the song much. I just saw the challenge on social media and was like, I like dancing, so I'm just gonna do it. I really don't want to post this vlog now. Like, what was I talking to you guys about today? Okay, so I'm still stressing out. I've been here for like 40 minutes editing the vlog. I've got to go and ride a horse for someone now. And then I'm going to get these things sorted out because they are just so long and catching everything on them. And then I'm going to come back and teach, and then I've got lates. But I don't know, just a proper mood killer. So yeah, I'll see you after I've ridden this horse and we'll go to Hereford. Okay, I'm back and I have new claws. And I feel better, by the way. Sorry about my mini meltdown. I think it's hilarious because this morning I'm like, yeah, I'm just going to do my thing. And then, like, I get one message, I'm like, but that's because this is all new for me and I'm learning how to deal with it. It'll be okay. I've spoken to a few people about it and I feel better. It's just one of those things, isn't it? You can't please everyone. But anyway, I'm going to go and teach now. It's 6:30. I'm going to go and teach, then come back in. Then I think I'm going to do late.
Lulu! Hi, Lulu. Hi, Flopsy Mopsy. Hi, Flopsy Mopsy. Hi! Yeah, you vlog famous now. That little sprout stealing your spotlight. Molly, do you love me? Are we riding? Say you'll never, never leave me.
So lesson is taught and it went really, really well. Now it is 7:30 and I was about to do the yard, but Laura said that her and Lauren are doing it, which is cool because then I can do some work, get some dinner. Should have gone to the gym. Oh, got a new PT, by the way. Coolest gym ever. Oh, also for you Love Island watchers, I don't watch it. One of the guys who is in Love Island at the moment is a PT at the gym I've started going to. So, yeah, probably bump into him when he gets back, but I won't even know who he is. That'd be awkward. So, that's the end of the vlog, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, make sure to... Make sure to like, share, tag a friend, and I'll see you for the next one.
Oh, I missed it. Oh, and then it's that. Okay. Oh. It's a kinky bit I can't do.
Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. Cause I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you always.